Hello guys, and welcome to another train review of mine. I'm now in Canberra, ACT. First, I'm going to catch the New South Wales TrainLink Coach to Yass. Then I'm going to catch the XPT to Melbourne Southern Cross Station.
New South Wales TrainLink is a state-owned coach and train operator providing services throughout New South Wales and into the ACT, Victoria and South Australia. Its coach stop in Canberra Civic is located on West Road, approximately 100 metres from Australia Post Canberra GPO and 200 metres from Alinga Street light rail stop. Canberra Civic coach stop is served by services to Cootamundra, Bumbala, Eden and Goulburn.
Reading. Yep, you're going through to Yass?
Yes.
Yep, cool, thank you.
While booking the ticket, each passenger was assigned to a seat, but no one seems to sit on their allocated seat, so you can just sit wherever you want. The seats are in a 2-2 configuration with ample legroom. The seats are reclinable. At the back of the coach, there's a toilet, but there's no Wi-Fi on board, nor USB plugs for you to charge your device. The coach that I'm catching today is number 781 from Queanbeyan to Cootamundra. This daily service mainly connects passengers in Canberra and Queanbeyan with the XPT to Melbourne at Yass Junction Station. This morning we left Canberra on time. The trip to Yass Junction takes around 1 hour.
Thanks. Good morning. My name's David, taking us through to Cootamundra this morning. We'll be heading out through Murra Embatement into Yass Town, then on to Yass Junction Station, where some of you will leave us to join the XPT. The coach does have a toilet on board, but we respectfully ask that unless it's an emergency that you do not use it. It's obviously difficult for us to keep clean with the current restrictions and with the roads that we travel on. The coach does move around a little bit, so if you are needing to use the toilet, please make sure you have a firm hold as you make your way there. Apart from that, sit back, enjoy the trip, and I'll give you more information once we get to Yass Junction at the train station. Thank you. Okay folks, we'll shortly be arriving around at Yass Junction Station. For those of you continuing on to Cootamundra and Harden, this is an opportunity for you to have a toilet break if you wish or just...
Yass Junction is a heritage listed railway station located 318 kilometres from Sydney Central. The facilities at this station include several toilets, train timetable, a map of the Yass Valley region and a ticket office which opens on weekdays. Built in 1877, the station illustrates the changes from early construction with single track operation to duplication and the need for a second platform with additional facilities, including refreshment rooms. However, nowadays trains coming from Melbourne and Sydney both use platform 1 at this station. The M31 Hume Highway is approximately 500 metres to the north. This morning the XPT left Sydney Central on time, but it was delayed at Goulburn Station for 15 minutes, which resulted the train to arrive at Yass Junction 20 minutes behind schedule. This kind of delay is quite common. The New South Wales XPT, short for Express Passenger Train, is based on the British Rail design high-speed train and entered service in April 1982. The train had a record speed of 193 km per hour and a top operating speed of 160 km per hour. The XPT operates two daily services from Sydney to Melbourne. On the night service, the train has three classes, first class sleeper, first class and economy class. On the day service, the train only had first class and economy class. In December 2020, I travelled in the first class sleeper. Today, I'm going to check out the economy class.
You both travelling?
No, I'm just travelling by myself.
Yeah. The economy class seats are in a 2-2 configuration. My seat was automatically allocated by the computer at the time of booking. Due to COVID-19, in order to allow social distancing on board, if you are traveling alone, you will get an empty seat next to you. The economy class seats on the XPT have really good amount of legroom. I can fully stretch my legs. I'm not 100% certain, but I believe they actually have more legroom than the first class seats on the Explorer train. There's a footrest at the back of each seat, and the seat provides 28 degrees of recline. The difference between first class and economy class on the XPT is that the first class seats have 2.5 inches more legroom and provide 40 degrees of recline instead of 28 degrees. But economy class is 30% cheaper.
Rubbish? Any rubbish?
Each seat has a net to place your belongings and a bag to put your rubbish. The crew actually collect your rubbish pretty regularly. There's also a tray table at the back of each seat. The table looks clean, but the best way to check is to wipe the surface with surface sanitizer. The tray table is indeed really clean. There are overhead luggage racks on either side of the train, and above each seat there's an individually controlled adjustable air vent. There's a switch next to each air vent. I switch it on and off, but nothing happened. If you know what the switches are for, please let me know in the comment section below. There are curtains in case you want to block the sun, but I never need them, because I don't want to miss even a second of the scenery outside. At the end of each car, there's a luggage rack and a toilet. The toilet is once again incredibly clean. Inside, there's a sink, hand wash dispenser, hand dryer, needle disposal box, non-alcohol-based hand sanitizer, which was added since the pandemic began, and a baby changing station. The accessible toilets on this train are located in the buffet and saloon. This was the first announcement I heard since I got on board the train almost an hour ago. I was actually really hungry and was waiting for the crew to announce today's meal options for lunch. I headed to the buffet car and learned that the crew announced the lunch option at 11 o'clock. Fortunately, the staff at the buffet was nice enough to heat a meal for me. But that means another 50-minute wait for my meal. I'm sure most people who got on board at Yass Junction wouldn't have had a chance to have lunch. I would really appreciate if the staff could make another announcement after departing Yass, so people that got on board at Yass Junction wouldn't miss out the hot lunch.
What we have available is a roast pork, a beef and black bean sauce stir fry, that's going to be the main, a vegetarian curry, just a roast pork.
Other than the hot meal, there are also meat pies, sausage rolls, fruit salad, sandwiches, etc., which are preheated and pre-made in the morning, so you don't have to wait 50 minutes to get those snacks. About an hour and a half after we left Yass Junction, we arrived at Cootamundra. It is a halfway point between Sydney and Melbourne by rail. The station's building is a Type 5 first-class brick station, originally dating from 1884, with various alterations in 1904 to 05, 1915 and 1943. The station itself is a major complex with a variety of buildings and an unusually designed first-class station building not seen elsewhere. The station building and its major platform's owning are of particular significance with amazing detail in both the building and the cast iron columns and brackets of the canopy. The station is also a major coach interchange which connects the town with Canberra Queanbeyan, Tumbra Mumba, Wagga Wagga, Griffith, Condobolin Town, Parkes, Dubbo and Bathurst. Roughly 55 minutes after I ordered my lunch, the meal had finally arrived. The meal costs $10.50 or $12.50 with a non-alcoholic drink. Today I ordered a roast pork and roast potato meal. The meal choices change every couple of months, but they always have a roast dish, Asian-style noodles, a spaghetti, and a vegetarian curry dish. The roast pork dish contains several slices of pork with gravy, as well as vegetables and roast potatoes. The pork tastes quite juicy and flavorful. This is probably the best frozen meal I've ever had. The meal also comes with a complimentary hot bread served with melted butter. I would recommend this meal if you are traveling long distance on this train. The portion is a bit small for me though. The whole meal is only 270 grams, so I'll likely have to order something else later on. Junee is another major station on the main Southern Railway line in New South Wales. The station was opened in 1878. The roundhouse and turntable arrangement at Junee consisted of 42 road roundhouses laid out in a radial pattern from a central turntable. It was the largest in the Southern Hemisphere when it opened in 1947. The Junee Roundhouse Railway Museum now preserves its former Junee locomotive depot after it was closed in 1993. At Harefield, the Melbourne-bound XPT met the Sydney-bound XPT. I'm surprised that the train actually travels faster than a car. This is very rare to see in Australia. About 7.5 hours after the train left Sydney, or 4 hours after we left Yass Junction, we arrived at Albury Station. The station was the terminus for the main Southern Line from 1881 until 1962. It remains as an operational railway yard and passenger station and is the last station before New South Wales-Victoria border. The Sydney-based XPT crew got off at this station. The remaining journey to Melbourne was run by the Albury crew. Other than the two daily XPT, V-Line also runs three daily train services between Albury and Melbourne.
If you're missing a station, I'll please come on down to the buffet. We have a couple to provide. So just a reminder, buffet and car seat open for service. Make sure to wear your face mask while avoiding our service. Thank you.
The first station that we just stormed past after entering Victoria is Wodonga. Because Albury to Melbourne section is also served by V-Line trains, the XPT only stops at Wangaratta, Benalla, Seymour and Broadmeadows in Victoria. Mask is still mandatory on public transport in Victoria, so make sure to bring a mask with you if you are travelling from New South Wales. I felt a bit hungry again, so I went to the buffet car and looked for a pie. The choices were either the chunky steak pie or disappointment, so I bought the last remaining pie on this train. The pie costs $5 and a can of Coke costs $3. From the condition of this pie, I believe it had been in the oven since the train left Sydney. I'm a fan of meat pies, and this steak pie just tastes like the average meat pies I had elsewhere in Australia. You know what a steak pie tastes like, right? After Benalla, the crew offered another main meal service. The choices were the same as lunch. This time I could hear the announcement loud and clear.
On the menu today we have a roast pork with beans, carrots and potato. We have a beef and black bean noodle with Chinese broccoli. We have a yellow Thai vegan vegetable curry with white rice and beans. And last best we have a spaghetti bolognese. All these meals cost $10.50 and take approximately 1 hour to heat up.
Since we are not far from Melbourne, most passengers, including me, decided to have dinner in Melbourne instead.
Ở ngay chỗ cái góc bùng rác á, của nhà mình á, con nhặt lá.
When you can see the skyscrapers in the background, you know you are not far from Melbourne. I'm not gonna say this 8-hour journey passed quickly, but it wasn't bad at all, especially when you get an empty seat next to you. It's definitely better than catching the coach. There's no power plug in economy nor in first class, but this can be easily solved by bringing your own power bank. There's no mobile reception throughout the journey except when the train stops at a station, but it's a good time to take a break from social media and actually enjoy the scenery outside the window. V-Line and New South Wales TrainLink both provide a daily coach plus train service from Canberra to Melbourne. With V-Line, you can catch the coach to Albury or Wodonga, then catch the train to Melbourne. With New South Wales TrainLink, you can catch the coach to Yass Junction or Cootamundra, then catch the XPT to Melbourne. Both services take around 8.5 hours. The V-Line First Class and New South Wales XPT Economy provide a similar level of comfort and charge the similar amount of money. Flights between Canberra and Melbourne usually cost around $165, so travelling by coach plus train is a great alternative. At Wagga Wagga, the XPT was 24 minutes behind schedule, but it was able to make up the time in Victoria and arrived at Southern Cross Station 5 minutes early. After arrival, one of the crew recognized me from my previous XPT video on YouTube, so he allowed me to film the buffet unrestricted. Thanks very much. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have enjoyed it, please don't forget to give it a like. Next week, I'll be travelling on the Overland Train Red Premium Class from Melbourne to Adelaide. Please subscribe to my channel if you'd like to see more train and flight reviews from me. I'll see you guys next week.